Writing is hard. Writing in English is hard. Writing an essay well in English when it isn't your first language?
Forget about it.
Hi, my name is Jonathan Prudek, and I teach English language and literature to high schoolers at an international school in South Korea. Every semester, I assign my students writing assignments, often on books like these. And the purpose of my action research is to help my students become better writers. I've been using written corrective feedback on my students' writing assignments, which looks something like this. Not surprisingly, this is time consuming, and I want to make sure I'm doing it the right way so that I'm actually helping my students. The problem is that I'm not sure what is the best way to use written corrective feedback, or WCF. Or if WCF is even the best way to help my students become better writers. Some studies have argued against WCF as a method for helping students, saying it's a waste of time and may actually impede on students' progress. For this reason, I set out to find the best way to help my students become better writers, because quite honestly, they face some significant challenges. Teaching any group of students how to write an academic essay is a challenge. But there are a few aspects of Hangul, the Korean written language, that make it particularly difficult for Korean students to acclimate to writing in English. Here's a sentence in Korean. 영어 글쓰기에서 가장 어려운 부분은 규칙들과 규칙들의 예외입니다. The most difficult parts of writing in English are the rules and the exceptions to the rules. There are a few things to notice here. First, Korean has no capital letters. Second, here are the words in order in case you don't speak Korean. English, writing, most difficult, is, / are, part, rules, rules, exceptions, is. The reason for this order is relatively straightforward. English typically follows a subject, verb, object pattern, like I went to the movie theater. Korean, on the other hand, follows a subject-object-verb pattern. 저는 영화관에 갔어요. I movie theater to went. In case you're wondering, Yoda uses a very unusual object-subject-verb pattern.
Powerful you have become, Dooku. The dark side I sense in you.
Korean doesn't use articles the same way English does, and plurals don't work the same way either. Add on top of that issues of word choice, spelling, subject-verb agreement, and tenses, and you've got a lot on your plate. So how do you help English language learners become better writers? Practice is a great place to start, but you can't just give a student a piece of paper, a pen, and a topic. How much practice should you give? What happens when they're done writing? Should you give feedback? How much feedback should you give? What's the right way to give feedback? Do you only go over technical issues like spelling and punctuation and grammar? Or do you go over big things like structure and flow? Today, I'm going to explain how I tried to answer three questions. Number one, how effective is written corrective feedback in improving the skills of English language learners? Number two, if WCF has been found to be an effective strategy for improving English language learners' skills, what do I need to do to make sure I'm implementing it correctly? And number three, what other strategies should I implement in addition to or instead of written corrective feedback? Thankfully, there's no shortage of peer-reviewed academic essays seeking to answer the question of whether or not written corrective feedback is useful. In the wake of Truscott's 1996 article, The Case Against Grammar Correction in L2 Writing Classes, researchers have tried to answer the question, is WC effective in improving L2, or English language learners, writing skills? For my literature review, I selected three peer-reviewed articles to answer each of my research questions. For the first question, how effective is written corrective feedback in improving the writing skills of English language learners, I turned to a 2018 study by Fan and Ma, who, as it turns out, asked the same questions I did. Is WCF useful? And how is WCF used effectively? Fan and Ma pointed to a 2007 study by Saxon Polio, in which students who received error correction were 32% more accurate than those who didn't. They also refer to acquisition theory as a theoretical framework to argue for the use of WCF. Acquisitions theory states that implicit learning, which takes place automatically, has to be preceded by explicit learning. Therefore, if students participate in a process of receiving explicit feedback and then practicing, they'll eventually make those changes automatically. So Fan and Ma's study provided a theoretical basis for WCF, and they pointed to at least one study that showed its effectiveness, but that still didn't answer my second question. What's the best way to use WCF? Should I use it for grammar? Like I said before, Truscott argued that WCF is ineffective and potentially harmful. So Meng, the second study I reviewed, wanted to find out what other researchers had to say in response to Truscott, and maybe reach a consensus on the issue. Ashwell and Ferris and Roberts argued that WCF has short-term effectiveness, but Truscott said these studies didn't show evidence of learning. Chandler argued that direct feedback increases students' writing accuracy, but Truscott and Gwinnett said the study failed to show evidence of superiority of corrective feedback since Chandler's studies didn't have a control group. After 2007, researchers buckled down to make sure studies were robust and had quasi-experimental designs. In each of these studies, students who received WCF outperformed control groups. So the nail's in the coffin. WCF almost definitely works. The question now is, what's the best way to use it? Should you focus on one thing, like spelling, or should you provide what's called unfocused feedback and cover a student's errors comprehensively? According to a study by Van Bloeningen, teachers shouldn't be afraid to throw the kitchen sink at a student's paper. So to recap, WCF almost definitely works, and WCF works when teachers cover students' errors en masse rather than selectively. Unfortunately, you can give feedback, even a lot of feedback, and still not help your students very much. This is where my third study by Mikume and Oyu comes in and gives more specific details on what makes good WCF and bad WCF. Let's start with the bad. Ineffective feedback is vague and inconsistent, subjective and arbitrary, overly negative, lacking information on where learners can improve. And the consequences of negative feedback can be that students aren't motivated to look beyond surface errors, are unable to be self-critical, and they may become frustrated, confused, or even despondent. Effective feedback, on the other hand, covers content, organization, and grammar, and is all the things that ineffective feedback is not. It's specific, it's consistent, it balances positive and negative comments. And research has shown that when feedback covers form and content, learners are more likely to incorporate both types of feedback in later compositions. So does this mean that you can give a student feedback that meets these criteria and call it a day? You could, but there's one more thing you could do to help your students out even more, which is called conferencing, where a teacher meets with a student to help explain the WCF they gave them. In each of these studies, it was found that students who received oral metalinguistic explanations after they received written corrective feedback outperformed the students in the control group. And Mikume and Oyu's research found that conferencing helps students get more focused and usable comments, provides opportunities for clarification, instruction, and negotiation, and conferencing gives teachers the opportunity to cover the diverse cultural, educational, and writing needs of their students. So to recap, Fan and Ma provided empirical and theoretical evidence of WCF's effectiveness. Meng found plenty of studies that refuted Truscott's claim, and Mikume and Oyu's research gave a list of the do's and don'ts for giving written corrective feedback. Since I was conducting action research, it was necessary to do some research at my own school, VCA Korea. To do this, I had several English teachers at both the middle and high school levels participate in a survey to find out their attitudes and approaches towards giving written corrective feedback. I also had students complete surveys to see how they feel about the feedback they receive from those same teachers, including myself, and to see how all the answers lined up. Lastly, I gathered examples of students' written work to compare against the survey answers I received. Here's what I found from surveying students at each level of high school. In response to the question, how useful is WCF for you? Every student answered that it is either somewhat useful or very useful. 73% of students said they attribute most of their improvement as writers to WCF. Students were also asked which aspects of WCF they find most useful for helping with writing. Incoming freshmen were more likely to say spelling or grammar, while incoming sophomores, juniors, and seniors were more likely to say content or structure. Students were also asked about their teachers' feedback in terms of the criteria for effective and ineffective feedback that was listed in Mikume and Oyu's research. Only one student gave an answer other than yes, as in always specific and consistent, or somewhat, as in mostly specific or consistent, with the lone holdout saying it depends on the teacher. 80% of students said they feel positively towards the criticism they receive, with the remaining 20% saying they feel neither positively nor negatively. Lastly, students were asked about the possibility of receiving feedback or conferencing from their peers. All of the rising freshmen said they are either somewhat interested or very interested. The majority of the older students, on the other hand, said they are not very interested or not at all interested. I have two theories for why the older students would be less inclined to get feedback from their peers. Number one, their writing assignments are harder, so they have less confidence that their peers would be able to help. Number two, older students might be more satisfied with the feedback they've already received from their instructor. The last theory is borne out in the suggestions section, actually, where younger students provided more suggestions, with several asking for more opportunities to write and receive feedback on their assignments. Which brings us to the teacher's survey. Every teacher said they are satisfied with the feedback they provide, which probably shouldn't come as any surprise. And every teacher said they cover every available aspect of writing feedback: spelling, punctuation, word choice, grammar, content, and structure. One caveat, however, is teachers were not allowed to specify the degree to which they provide one or the other. For example, a teacher wasn't able to specify that they devote the majority of their written corrective feedback to, say, content and structure rather than grammar or word choice. However, the frequency with which teachers have been providing writing assignments with written corrective feedback is telling. The teachers with older students, as in rising sophomores, juniors, and seniors, said they think students should be given writing assignments with feedback weekly, while teachers with younger students, that's middle schoolers and incoming freshmen, said writing assignments with feedback should be given either once or twice a month. These are the same teachers whose students said they wish they received more writing assignments with feedback. This is where my third data source, students' actual written assignments, comes in. Although every teacher who participated in the survey indicated that they cover almost every available aspect of feedback, there's a clear correlation between students' ages and the kind of feedback they receive. Younger students in 8th and 9th grade received more technical feedback, such as grammar, spelling, and punctuation suggestions, while older students received technical suggestions in addition to holistic suggestions on ways to improve an essay's structure, flow, and content. These findings suggest that teachers with younger students may be less inclined to provide regular writing assignments with feedback, since the kind of feedback they provide is more technical. Given the overwhelmingly positive attitude students have towards feedback, as well as the evidence pointing towards the value of written corrected feedback, you would think it would be as easy as telling teachers just to give more writing assignments with feedback. This is where my future action plan and force field analysis comes in, to see if there's anything I can do to increase the amount of writing assignments with feedback that teachers give. My action plan had four goals. Number one, to improve my students' writing skills, first and foremost. Number two, to establish the usefulness of WCF as a method for improving L2 writing skills. Number three, create a standardized approach for providing WCF, particularly for students at all grade levels. And number four, explore the efficacy of peer feedback. The objectives of the action plan are to conduct quasi-experimental research to examine the effectiveness of written corrective feedback and peer feedback in addition to WCF, and determine the best practices for providing WCF at different grade levels, Answers to these questions will help teachers know how to give WCF to students in different grades in terms of whether they should focus on technical or holistic details and whether peer feedback would be an asset to the feedback process. The objectives have a few driving forces in their favor. Teachers have the right attitude about WCF, that it should be for the sake of helping students improve rather than just for the sake of grading. Number two, teachers are already providing WCF in various forms. Number three, students feel positively towards WCF and attribute most, if not all, of their improvement as writers to WCF. Number four, incoming freshmen all expressed at least some interest in receiving peer feedback. Number five, the validation of peer feedback as a strategy would mean teachers spend less time on corrections and students may still improve as writers. And lastly, a strong research base for the implementation of WCF, focused and unfocused WCF, WCF with conferencing, and the use of peer feedback. Unfortunately, there are a few barriers to success, or restraining forces. A couple of these are out of my control. Teachers may be reluctant to change their approaches. And the fact that both teachers and students are predominantly satisfied with WCF means both groups may actually be reluctant to participate. Those are out of my control. What is at least partly in my control is teachers' attitudes towards teacher feedback. Here's why. Even though teachers may be reluctant to provide more writing assignments based on the findings of the research, I might be able to persuade teachers that using peer feedback may mean they spend less time on corrections. As for the lack of enthusiasm among the high school students, if I can give specific instructions on how feedback can and should be given, and give students opportunities to work with each other, they may be inclined to pursue peer feedback as a course of action. The success of the research could be assessed qualitatively or quantitatively. Students' writing scores on their TOEFL, SAT, or school writing assignments could serve as data points, while surveys and interviews could be conducted to assess teachers' and students' levels of satisfaction with adjustments made to how feedback is given. Written corrective feedback is a powerful tool that can be used to help students improve their ability to communicate through the written word. The challenge that comes with using written corrective feedback, or any powerful tool for that matter, is knowing how to use it. Thankfully, a lot of research have done the legwork of showing us not only that WCF works, but how to make it work. It may take time for teachers to adapt, and you know what they say about old dogs, but it's all a process. Learning how to write, writing, and apparently, teaching how to write.